What's up, Jet Nation? This is Chris Gardella coming at you with an update on the Jets' search for a new GM. According to Adam Schefter, the Jets have invited back four candidates for a second round of interviews, which happened this week. So it would appear that we are nearing the finish line here, and we'll hopefully have a new GM in place and finalized by middle to end of next week, hopefully at the latest. With that said, according to all media reports, the Eagles' Joe Douglas continues to be the number one target for Christopher Johnson. But we are starting to hear some rumblings that and rumors, unconfirmed reports, that Joe Douglas has actually removed himself from consideration for the role, all because of a salary dispute. Apparently, there was $1 million gap between what the Johnson brothers were offering and what Joe Douglas was willing to accept. And we are supposed to believe that he has now walked away and said, I'll stick it out with the Eagles for another year and wait until another opportunity opens up in 2020. I find this to be probably a false narrative that's been issued by the Douglas camp, and rightfully for good reason. Number one, the Johnson brothers are notoriously cheap when it comes to paying general managers and head coaches. That's not a secret across the league. It's not a secret across the media. It's not a secret across the fan base. So it would appear to me that we're seeing some kind of high stakes kind of poker game being played from the Douglas camp with the Johnsons, and both trying to finagle their way to either save a few bucks if you're the Johnsons or to make a few bucks if you're Joe Douglas. So I think this is Joe Douglas trying to create leverage and to essentially scare, call the Johnson brothers bluff, squeeze an extra couple $100,000 a year out of him. Anyone who lives in the New York metro area knows that that's probably a smart decision. High taxes, high cost of living. If you're getting paid $1 million a year, it's great money, don't get me wrong, but it's not going to be money that you just, you know, 1 year, 2 years, and you retire on. You're probably going to have to go out and work if this gig doesn't work out for you. Joe Douglas probably knows that, and so he's trying to get whatever he can from the Johnson brothers. Kudos to you. Get what you can from them. With that said, I find it unlikely that Joe Douglas walks away from this opportunity for really two reasons. Number one, the Jets, despite the narrative that they are a complete laughingstock, a joke, an organization in chaos, they do have some things to like, number one being Sam Darnold. Joe Douglas is going to walk into a situation where he's got Sam Darnold locked up for four more years on a rookie contract. He can go out and deploy all that extra money in free agency, build a team with whatever vision he has. He also walks in knowing that there's $30 million in cap space available to him. So he's got a lot of wiggle room to maneuver around and find players to fill some holes that the Jets obviously have going forward. At the end of the day, you know, I don't want to see games being played here. If Joe Douglas is the number one target of the Johnson brothers, then let's skip the games, guys, and go out and go pay him what he wants. The bottom line is that if you're the Johnsons, you can't have your cake and eat it too. And what I mean by that is you can't decide to fire a general manager in May after you let him control the draft and free agency, and then also decide that you're going to go ahead and squeeze your number one target and basically force him to succumb into accepting whatever offer it is that you have. The media has painted this ownership structure and the Johnson brothers in particular as being a complete joke with how they handled the firing of Mike Maccagnan. If you're the Johnson brothers and you want to take control of the narrative from here, then you have to at least give the perception to the media and the fan base that you have a plan and that you're able to execute on that plan. And from all the reports that we're reading, and they could be wrong, the reports are that the Jets fired Maccagnan because they wanted Joe Douglas. If that is true, then you really shouldn't be risking losing Joe Douglas over $1 million a year. The $1 million a year is the tax that you have to pay to the fan base to show them that you have a plan and you're able to execute on that plan. And you don't get to have your cake and eat it too. So Christopher Johnson, if you're watching, just pay Joe Douglas the money so that we can get on with our offseason and hopefully win 10 games next year, which, by the way, is what Manish Mehta said we would win, even though just a week ago, we were the laughingstock of the NFL. Thanks for watching, guys. If you liked what you saw, give it a like, subscribe, and until next time, we'll see you later.